dance series. The last video we went through the history of ballet. This video begins with remarkable pioneers of ballet art. Let's go into the artistic life of ballet masters. Ballet originated in Italy. However, the French court in the 17th century provided an important environment for developing ballet. The third king of the Bourbon dynasty in French history, Louis XIV, Louis Dieudonne Bourbon, 1638-1715, was later known as the King of the Sun. Louis XIV has been called the embodiment of authoritarian, the emperor who unified Europe, loved and played a great role in the evolution of literature and arts. Dance activities were significant in the regiment during Louis XIV. King of the Sun, Louis XIV, born in 1638 in France. By the age of 32, he had starred in 26 major dance projects. In 1653, the young king, who was only 15 years old, performed a series of dances in Ballet Royal de la Nuit, and at the last minute he wore a Roman-style golden armor and short skirt. From then, he called himself Apollo, the god of the sun in Greek myth, to highlight his supreme and authority, and it's been the origin of the King of the Sun. In the 17th century, France became the most prosperous nation in economy, culture and arts in Europe during that period. This era was proudly called the Great Century by the French. Louis XIV had many important initiatives in his life. One of the most striking achievements of his monarchy is the construction of the Palace of Versailles, which is famous in the architectural history. Versailles has corridors in the shape of radiation, which symbolizes the Sun King's light. Even the palace's hall was named Apollo Hall. The fountain landscape in the gardens has two statues of the Apollo and his mother. It not only does show the supreme kingship, but also records the luxurious life of the royals of Louis XIV court. Louis XIV usually wears extremely luxurious royal robes and costumes and pair with his favorite high heels and fluffy wig to create an image of the king. There are a variety of banquets, dances and celebrations in the palace every day. He developed the hobby of dancing in the court and created an excellent atmosphere for the initiation of court ballet. The royals enjoyed luxury and romance in this magnificent palace, and nobles show off their arts talents. In this background, the court ballet gradually developed and possessed the noble and elegant temperament from the inside out. Louis XIV and his creative team, composer Jean-Baptiste Lully, playwright Molière and dancer Beauchamps are important persons who lays the foundation of ballet. Louis XIV began to learn dance when he was young and received good training. His first performance on stage was at the age of 15. Louis XIV has played a leading role in many ballet performances. He made ballet one of the most important elements of the cultural life of the court at that time. His excellent artistic talent and his love for ballet have made him a groundbreaking figure in the history of ballet. However, Louis XIV's artistic achievements are inseparable from the important contributions of the three masters mentioned above. They are responsible for music, theater and ballet. Jean-Baptiste Lully was well-versed in music and dance and later became the king's favorite dancer, and called him the best dancer in France who can compete with the king. He worked with Molière and Beauchamp to create a style known as comedy ballet or dramatic ballet. That is, integrate drama into ballet performance, so that the ballet performance will have more dramatic effect. He also incorporated the form of chaconne music into ballet performances. Chaconne is a kind of dance music that originated in Spanish colonies such as Mexico. It was introduced to Spain in the 16th century and became popular in Europe in the 17th century, mostly in opera and keyboard music. Pierre Beauchamps is a famous French ballet artist and teacher. He also played a significant role in the establishment of ballet. In 1661, Louis XIV found the Royal Academy of Dance in Paris, the world's first Royal Academy of Dance. One of the world's leading dance companies, the Paris Opera Ballet, was transformed from that academy. Beauchamp was the first dean under his leadership. The Royal Academy of Dance pioneered the technical norms of ballet. He has led 13 dance teachers to organize and regulate the basic movements of ballet, define the basic position of hands and feet works in ballet training, so the ballet term we use today is still in French. Since then, ballet began its professional path. To cultivate professional ballerina, of course, has become an increasingly large project in the academy. Therefore, ballet performance gradually from the court into the theater, more and more general audiences can see this elegant art form. Due to age, weight, etc., Louis XIV no longer performs ballet on stage. As a result, the court nobility gradually withdrew from the ballet stage. Ballet performance gradually from court art changed to theater art, from amateur entertainment to professional performance. Yet the former Sun King remains a loyal patron and supporter of ballet. Louis XIV was obsessed with dancing, and even the court doctor advised him that he would fall ill for overpractice. However, Louis XIV was very healthy. Instead, he became the oldest emperor in French history. Long to Louis XV was his great-grandson. It seems that dance not only delights the body and mind, but also increase the longevity. Ballet in the following 300 years of development and revolution has spread throughout the world. Louis XIV's contribution to the development of early ballet has become an important chapter in the history of world dance. The elegant style he advocated has also become synonymous with ballet art. The second stage, let's walk into the period of Romantic ballet. How did ballet transform into a classic foot-tip movement? What's the story behind such an iconic dance? Our story today is here. Welcome, leave your comment, tell us your questions during the study of dance, or anyone who wants us to make a video for your ideas, welcome to email us. I leave the address in the video description. Thanks for your watching, I'll see you next time.